Welcome to 1362 East Cherry. Now, today we're gonna take a tour of this super, super cool property. Now, there's all sorts of videos on YouTube of people reviewing $100 million mansions, you know, the $300 million The One. But what if I showed you some reasonably attainable, luxurious properties here in the Midwest area? This is listed for $599,000. It was built in the 1930s, fully renovated, 5-bedroom, 3-bath, with 2 cars, and it's 4,100 square feet, 3-story home. I'm really excited to show you a tour of this. I'm out of breath because I had to turn on the camera and run up. It's a big house, and run up here and film the intro, but regardless, I hope you enjoy. Now let's go inside and meet the listing agents.
Hi, my name is Wim Oakes. I'm a real estate agent here in Springfield, Missouri. So this gorgeous home has been renovated by the sellers. They maintained most of the charm that they could while also updating it to more modern standards. LED lighting, new HVAC, new roof, new fixtures. They refinished the floors, repainted everything. If they could keep the original classy architecture, they did. So we are Win-Win Real Estate, powered by Keller Williams here in Springfield, Missouri. We're a husband-wife team. We've been realtors for over 6 years. We've been real estate investors for over 17 years. I'm a retired ICU nurse. I did that for over 20 years. I got out of nursing just last year. I've been doing this part-time. But I felt that I could give my knowledge and value and experience to people that have never bought a home before. Mm-hmm. And we bought several homes ourselves, so we felt like we can definitely give back to our clients, our friends, our family, and all the learning mistakes that we've done, all the home purchases, things like that. Mm-hmm. So I'm still helping people. It's just not at the bedside, it's in a home.
Also, I feel like a strength for our team is the fact that we did so much in real estate prior to being agents that we still relate to buyers, and you can benefit from all of our mistakes we made as buyers. But we help investors, we do residential, commercial.
First-time homeowners.
First-time homeowners and sellers, buyers. Anywhere in Southwest Missouri. All of our contact information for Win-Win Real Estate you'll find in the description box of this video. We look forward to hearing from you and helping you with your future real estate needs.
And also, let me tell you about my good friends at Webull, one of the number one online stock brokerages on the planet, and I've been using them for 4+ years. Commission-free trading, the app is free, there is no subscriptions, it's free, free, free. And better yet, they're gonna pay you to sign up in the form of a sign-up bonus. That's right, folks, a sponsor for today's video that is going to pay you instead of the other way around. All you got to do is click the link in my description, download Webull, open an account, deposit as little as 1 cent, and they're going to give you 5 free stocks valued all the way up to $9,600 plus $5 worth of free crypto if you also open a crypto account with them. So yeah, I can't say I often see on YouTube brand deals that the audience gets paid instead of the audience paying the brand deal. Anyway, if you like money, if you like free money, definitely take advantage of this limited time sign-up bonus. So first, we're gonna start here in this very spacious, beautiful living room. And immediately, you can see what I was talking about earlier of the updated light fixtures and the trimming around the windows are just in perfect shape. Fresh paint on the walls, the flooring is beautiful. Now, I do need to mention that the piano, the couch, none of the living room furniture will be selling with the house, but it does kind of put a good perspective on what you could do with the space to make it your home. Now, moving into the dining room, you can see there is a really big table, lots of space in here. The camera is actually sitting in the living room, so you're in the living room, facing the dining room, and then the kitchen is right here. Brand new, super, super cool light fixture. It's really unique. In fact, I've never seen this one. I really like it. And you've actually got a built-in real fireplace. We're not totally sure if it's functional. Right now it is an Airbnb, so it is not being used, it's boarded up, but either way, it's a really, really cool look to a cozy dining area. And another feature with this cool built-in fireplace is actually built-in shelving. One of my favorite features and something that I have
at my personal place, and I really, really like it. And as many of us may know, and as it's probably true for you, the kitchen is one of the main selling points of the home. And this kitchen does not let down. It has a beautiful long island. The cabinets have been updated. Modern looking hardware, real solid granite countertops, and it just matches the light cabinetry very well. And as you can see, the white tile backsplash is also a very classy touch. Another point that I really like is this big, deep, wide farmhouse style sink. Super cool, and you can cook lots of good meals in here for you, your family, and your friends. Off of the kitchen is the stairway down to the recreational room basement, but we're actually gonna come back to that in a little bit later. And another thing that I just really personally like about this island is the attention to detail down here. It's got a cool design, it's just not solid. It looks really cool. And here is the first bedroom off of the dining room. Now, it's kind of hard to tell which one exactly is the master because they're all just so big and spacious. So I would consider some of the ones upstairs the masters, which we'll get to in a little bit, but this is the perfect room to do room things. Do you see that? Another cool kind of high-end tech feature in this renovated Victorian-style house is the motion sensors in some of the rooms and closets, like the laundry rooms and the bathrooms and the closets. Just a cool touch. Nice walk-in closet. We've got built-in shelving here, and it's got plenty of space. So now we're in the first bathroom. This would be the bathroom that would get the use out of that bedroom we were just in, and also this is off of the dining room. So this is pretty much where most of your guests will probably be using the toilet. I really like what they've done with the backsplash here. It's actually my favorite color, so they must have done it just for me. Double vanity and the tile, it's just really cool. Also off of the dining room is your first laundry room. Now there's actually two, one here, one on the second floor. So if you're really lazy and you don't want to go up and down stairs, you should consider buying this home. For that fact alone, honestly. And right next to the laundry room is probably, it would make a really good home office as it's a smaller bedroom. It's not really that small. It's just, you know, in perspective with all of the other really, really big bedrooms in this place. But this would make a perfect kid's bedroom or really just a home office on the main floor. So now we've covered all of the rooms on the main floor. So let's move upstairs where things actually kind of get pretty cool. Also off of the dining room is the stairs to the second story. Now, keep in mind, like I said, the dining room's really big. That's why there's so many rooms off of it. But anyway, moving upstairs. Now, we're on the second story. Now, behind you is a miniature staircase leading into some rooms, but we'll get into that in a second. Up here, you have a really cool hallway. I like the railing, but you've got like a built-in desk right here. I just think that's super cool. And on either side of you, you have two really spacious closet spaces. And the one to your left is almost the size of a small room just for storage. Super cool. Moving back here, the hallway just goes and goes and goes and keeps going. It's still going, and then bam, rooms. But before we go all the way back there, right down there, another laundry room right here, another kids' room, office, a cool space. Let's take a look. Personally, I'm a sucker for rooms that are weird shapes. And this, my friend, is a strange shape. That's why I think it would be a perfect kids' room, you know, a small media room, or a really, really cool home office. And notice the light fixtures on the wall with their own independent switches. That's just a really, really cool feature that they didn't necessarily need to add, but it's here because at the end of the day, this is a cool house. Just off of that room on the other side of the hallway, more storage. So one thing about this house, it's plenty of storage. So if you got stuff, get this house. Anyway, moving into here, we have a laundry room. Oh, look at that, another motion sensing light, how cool. Washer and dryer, plenty of space, and a built-in granite countertop because even when you're doing your laundry, everything in this house is luxurious. And just for more perspective, you're now at the other end of the hallway. I will make my way down here. And these railings are actually custom. So that's super cool. And this is what I was talking about earlier. This miniature staircase all the way down here. I'm still going. I'm not even sure if you can see me down here, but we'll get down to here in a second. Right where you're standing is two of probably my two favorite rooms in this whole place, and I'll show you why. So here's one of the bedrooms on the second story, one of the ones I was telling you about that's super cool. Not only because it's super spacious, not only because it has really cool vaulted ceilings, not only because it has a really cool bathroom, which you're standing in right now, by the way, but I really like the private balcony. It's a perfect place to stand in the morning with a cup of Joe and yell at people driving too fast. Now, even though this is probably considered the master bedroom because it has a really cool bathroom off of the bedroom, the next room is actually probably my favorite, but let me show you the bathroom. And coming into the bathroom, first of all, it's big. Second of all, it has awesome built-in shelving right here to keep your towels. You know how much I love that. Cabinetry up to almost all the way in the ceiling. Of course, new light fixtures, double vanity with really just cool looking cabinets. You open this up, plenty more storage, lots of storage in here. And you are standing in a really, really big, super cool with built-in shelves. You know how much I love that. Walk-in closet. It's gonna be really hard for me to kind of show you this space. So I'll just play the GoPro footage right here to get a good wide angle shot, but built-in shelves right here, built-in shelves right here, and more over there. Lots of storage. If you've got lots of clothes, this can accommodate. And it comes with a hidey hole. You could probably rent that sucker out alone. Now we are moving into my favorite bedroom. It does not have its own bathroom, but it is my favorite. Of course, it has the nice higher vaulted ceilings. I think this probably has the most room, and everything in this room you actually see comes with the house. This super, super cool bed frame. You could even do pull-ups on that bad boy, I bet, although I wouldn't recommend it. And super cool, perfect fitting for the house. End tables, nightstands, whatever you want to call them. This has a lot of room. Of course, another very spacious walk-in closet right here. Unfortunately, this one doesn't have a hidey hole, but it does have built-in shelves, and you're standing in front of the balcony. And to put into perspective how big this room really is, you are sitting on one wall, and I will go all the way to the other. And look at this. This room's so big, you just gotta take a load off every once in a while and just take in your magnificent new home. Well, okay, I'm not gonna open that. And of course, you have another private balcony. Now, you remember the weird little mini staircase I was talking about earlier? Well, this is that. This right here, that's the main staircase. But it drops down, I almost fell, and goes into even more rooms. All right, coming down the staircase, you get into another room with giant windows. I like this room because it has a lot of natural lighting. And this has some cool features in this room. Even though it's not the biggest, this actually might be my favorite room, and you'll see why here in a second. So just to the left of where you're sitting is kind of a little storage area, built-in shelves, we like that. And you come into here, you see the nice high ceilings, the lots of natural light, and right over here to the left of me is this kind of like cutout. It's a different way of going about having a closet, and I really like it. And just kind of going back to how I think this house is just really unique and has a lot of character, there's just this extra little space, table and chairs, for you to sit and ponder on how cool your new home is. This is not why this might be my favorite room. The lighting might not be the reason it's my favorite room. The cool little closet cutout? No. The reason that this is probably my favorite room is because it has a super cool loft area. Now, it is an Airbnb. There's no ladder up there because that would be a bad idea. Liability waiting to happen. But if you were to own this home, I bet you would put one up there. Now, if you have a small friend, you know, maybe a pint-sized neighbor. And if you don't mind facing each other while you sleep, you could probably rent that out to any Yahoo off the street. Just another example of how this property is super cool and super unique. And of course, you have your own really private bathroom. Now, it's not built off of the room, as you see, but you're kind of on your own wing of the second story. So unless someone wants to take a hike all the way down from the other room, which they probably won't because that's, I mean, you're getting your steps in if you're doing that a couple times a day. This is basically your own private bathroom. And of course, it has a very spacious two-car garage, comes with a Sweet Echo. Now you might be wondering, why don't you open the garage? Why don't you make the lighting better? Because the garage makes loud noises and we don't like that. Now, coming down the stairs off of the kitchen, you have to watch your head here. And if you have teenage boys, prepare for this wall to get slapped quite a bit. Anyway, moving into the completely finished basement. Very spacious, super cool. As you can see, there is plenty of room to do whatever people do in basements. Now, the way it's set up now, there is a nice small little couch right here, an entertainment center with a TV. You've got a full-size dining room table and plenty of room if you like air hockey, if you like to get arcade machines, if you like pool tables. Whatever things that you're into, this space can accommodate. And I'm sure of it. And I'll prove it to you You like to jog? There you go, you can do it. Over here. Over here is the only part of the home that is not finished, and it's simply just storage. And when you're storing things, you don't necessarily want it to be finished anyway. As you can see, place to put things. And on a note, it smells really good in here. Don't know why, it smells really good. I hope you guys enjoyed. This is a super cool, unique property. I think that not only did it make a really good YouTube video, this will make a fantastic home for anybody. It's super unique, it's really big, plenty of storage, and plenty of built-in shelves. Anyway, if you enjoyed the video, hit that like and subscribe button. And you know, I know YouTubers always say comment down below for engagement, but I'm genuinely curious. Comment down below what your favorite room was. My favorite room was probably the cool bedroom on the second story with that loft. So definitely comment down below. I'm curious what you thought the coolest part of this was. If you enjoyed me bringing you this super cool property, be sure to let me know in the comments below. And that's it for this house tour. A special thanks to Wim and Anita Oaks. Do not forget that if you are looking to buy a home in the Springfield Mo kind of greater area, their information is linked in the description below and they will help you out. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video.